Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. It's awesome that you're tuning in. So in this video, it's going to be pure nostalgia and no package from China because we picked up this brick game and seemed very long time ago when I was hunting on some flea market and some thrift shops. And I came across this thing, and the reason I picked it up because this is the real old deal, the real old school stuff that I picked up back in the day when I was a child. Yep. Let me know in the comments, did you ever own a brick game and what do you think of it? So nowadays in China, we can buy these really flimsy chemical versions, like they are like nothing compared with this version. So that's the reason I picked it up, and I just want to make a video about it because this is for me like pure nostalgia. But let's see what kind of games are on it. Let's play some games, but first let's add some batteries. Oh, the old days. Like I had a Game Boy, but also had like a brick game. They were selling these things in all kinds of weird form factors, but this was the first edition that I got, and it's more like I had these weird games like Frogger and Tetris. And nowadays we can still pick it up. This one is a little bit busted up. I cleaned it up and I just want to leave it in this condition because this is just pure nostalgia. But let me know in the comments, what do you think of this? Because this called it the Brick Game 999-in-1, the Commodore A999. And if you turn around, it's going to be 666. Yeah. But yeah, like this old school LCD display in it. I did pick up in the past when I started this channel a couple of them, and most of them were like broken. And I was curious if this thing was even working. But yeah, basically these brick games are like Tetris games. Sometimes they're like multi-games, but that's the question. Is it actually like the multi-game like back in the day? All right, so we can go left, right, and here says level, speed, mode. And the reason why, because when you're going to get in the menu, you can choose the speed, you can change the mode, and of course the level. And here you can see some things changing, rotation direction, on and off. We can mute it and start the game. And the fun thing is, like, when I'm playing the ones from AliExpress, they don't make the sound, like it doesn't do anything, like having this weird sound in the beginning, like, so let's kind of have a music, but they don't make this music, like this tune. Oh, silence is much better. It's kind of interesting. But the first thing I noticed, like, that is different. Let's pause it. So the first thing I'm noticing, like, even they call it the 999 or the 666. The thing is, like, there is nothing, like, there's nothing comparable with the Chinese version because the plastic is way thick, non-chemical, but also the games. Like, this thing is completely made like a Tetris clone, let's say a brick game. And with the previous models, we have seen it comes with Frogger games, Race games, and all other kinds of versions. Okay, so let's take a close look at the menu itself. So here we can change the level. Oh crap, I want to have level 0. Okay, so let's put it on speed number 1. But the weird thing, like, we're having different modes, but it doesn't say anything to me. Like, I'm guessing this is the thing that they mean, like, with 99. Yep, you can go all the way up there. Holy shit, that is a lot. Let's go to level 100. Let's start. Let's see what happens now. It does have music, that's pretty cool. And then it stops. But still really cool. Oh, and I have never heard the Chinese version do that, you know? What the hell? So I'm just gonna be honest, there is no instruction. I have no idea what just happened. But in my opinion, it's kind of cool. I'm a big fan of the Tetris, so for me, like, I can enjoy playing this. Oh, we can just do it like that. Okay, so this is a kind of interesting way to play Tetris. Ah, crap. Oh, wait, I know how we can do this. Let's see if the trick works. Can we go? Come. Press to the left, press to the left. Yeah. So you have different kind of blocks that do that. I have no idea, so give me the shooting one. That was really convenient. I'm just going to be honest, I can play this all day. I love it. No idea why that makes that noise. Going great, going great. Almost. Why does it make that weird sound? But yeah, you get the point. It's Tetris. But shall we look in the inside? How does the device even look? I find it quite interesting that they're not selling this anymore, so far I know. Like the way they sell it, what I already mentioned, like they're selling these devices more like multi-devices. So now we're going to get a racing game, a tank game, stuff like that. It's kind of strange that they're not selling it like the brick game as it is now. To be honest, I personally prefer to have this version. Sounds maybe kind of weird because it only has more like only Tetris. Oh, crap, I think. Oh, that fits. But I do like Tetris, and the Frogger game and the other ones, like, okay, in my opinion, didn't really work on the other one. All right, so let's open it up. Let's put all of the burgers over here, otherwise I will lose a couple of them. And let's do a quick peek in the inside. So first of all, what you're going to get is not a lot. So the only thing that we're going to get is a battery compartment, two PCBs, and a speaker. The speaker itself, I don't know if it's similar to the ones they are using now. This thing goes freaking loud and I would like it. So the cables are all soldered to the PCB over here because this is the main PCB that has all the function and that also includes the games. Over here we're going to get some weird cheap wires. The soldering quality itself is not bad at all. And here we're going to get, of course, the PCB for the control panel. Okay, over here we're going to get a capacitor. And let's remove the other six screws because I want to give you a look in the inside. So this is basically the main board itself, everything that contains like the chip. I would not be surprised if we're going to open it up and I cannot show you in chip or whatever, because most of the time they're using blobs on these things just to protect their IP or something like that. But the construction wise is quite interesting in my opinion. You need to take consideration this thing is like freaking old and the technology was completely different back then. So it says here E1999. All right, so let's lift it up. So that is what it is. So it seems to be like the screen itself, it's attached to this PCB. I can't remove it. I'm just going to leave it over there, but you can already see like over there, there is a black blob, so there is nothing much to see. I know like with the Chinese version, it's a very tiny screen, super cheap. And most times they are like, you can separate them from the PCB itself. So yeah, that's it. I just want to give you a quick look in the inside, how it looks in the old school brick games. All right, guys, I hope you really enjoyed this video. For me, it was more like a quick revisiting of this brick game from back in the 90s. Like the good old days where we can pick up a brick game, and it was not really bad quality in my opinion. Like they are made very cheaply, but not as cheap like nowadays. You can pick them up like in all the kinds of form factors, but they don't so far I know have the same firmware. But thank you for watching, consider subscribing, hit the little bell, become on the Wicked family, and we'll see you in the next video.